Hi, welcome to the other 167. Once again, we welcome all of you all. If you do not subscribe to the channel, do subscribe to the YouTube channel, follow us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and do hit the bell icon when you subscribe to our channel, the other 167. Today, being Palm Sunday, we have another speaker who's going to come to talk to us. We had Daniel Schwarzenegger who came in the morning, and now we've got Stafford Cripps. So, without wasting time, let's just go and listen to what Stafford Cripps has to say to us.
Praise the Lord. Greetings to you all in the most precious and wonderful name of our Lord and Redeemer Jesus Christ. We are going to celebrate Palm Sunday. Prophet Zechariah wrote centuries ago in the form of prophecy in chapter 9 verse 9 about this great event to take place in the city of Jerusalem. I would like to read that verse to you. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion, shout, O daughter of Jerusalem, behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding on a donkey, a colt, the foal of a donkey. This prophecy was fulfilled word to word in Matthew's Gospel, 21st chapter, 5th verse. There we read, tell the daughter of Zion, behold, your king is coming to you, lowly and sitting on a donkey, a colt, a foal of a donkey. It was about 1,987 years ago, all the roads led to the city of Jerusalem. Jerusalem, the city of God, the city of peace, the city of hope, the city of light, the Zion Hill was visibly shaken. Heroes had come and gone. They always entered the city on prancing horses, but this hero came on a donkey, humbly and peaceably. The conquering hero entered the city in an incongruous procession. Prayers and praises were loudly raised. Jerusalem, curious and fascinated, inquired of the jubilant crowd, who is this? Who is this? Who is this? The crowd joyously and instantaneously answered, saying, this is Jesus, the son of David. This is Jesus, the miracle worker. And some of them had said, this is Jesus, the one who gave eyes to the blind, who made lame to walk, who released the demons, who gave life to the dead. Even Lazarus, the other day, after 4 days. Yes, there was great jubilation in Jerusalem. But dear brothers and sisters, within a matter of few days, the same people who waved palm branches and welcomed Jesus, spreading out their colorful garment on the road, they clamored for his blood. They yelled and screamed to release Barabbas instead of Jesus. In Matthew's Gospel, 27th chapter, 19th verse, we read, while Pilate was sitting on the judgment seat, his wife sent him the message, don't have anything to do with this innocent man, for I have suffered a great deal today in a dream because of him. But did Pilate heed to the advice of his wife? No, he was after power and position. Yes, in Hebrews 7:26 we read, Jesus Christ was holy, harmless, undefiled, and separate from sinners. He never committed sin. Pilate knew this. But then, what was the decision? The governor and the judge of that great Roman Empire, the lawmaker, became a lawbreaker in submitting to the howling mob, an innocent and righteous man to be crucified. Yes, dear brothers and sisters, when Barabbas heard about Jesus being crucified in his place, I imagine a scene. Barabbas, when he was released from the prison, might have run across towards Mount Golgotha. He might have knelt before Jesus Christ and he might have asked the Lord, Lord, why I should have been crucified? But Jesus Christ, the Son of God and the Lamb of God, might have said, Barabbas, I am dying in your place on your behalf. What are you going to do for me? Yes, I am sure Barabbas may be possible. He became a missionary because of the love of Christ that he demonstrated on the cross of Calvary. Dear brothers and sisters, Jesus died not merely in the place of Barabbas, not merely in the place of Judas, not for the Jewish people, not for the Pharisees or the Sadducees. He died for my sins and your sins, sins of the whole world. Yes, King David asked a very vital, very important question in Psalm 116 verse 12. What shall I give unto thee, O Lord, in return for all the benefits they are given to me? What shall I give unto thee in return? We have to ask the same question. Lord, what shall I give in return for your great love and sacrifice? Yes, St. Paul answers this question in Romans 12, 1 and 2. I beseech you, my dear brethren, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto the Lord. Yes, as we celebrate Palm Sunday, let us humble before God. Let us pray, Lord, break me, melt me, mold me, cleanse me, and fill me with thy spirit, so that in the short span of time, I'll be able to reach out to people with your love, which is so amazing, which is so marvelous, and win precious souls for you. May the Lord add his blessings to the hearing of the word. Shalom, and God bless.
Well, Jesus died for your sins, Jesus died for my sins, Jesus died for all of our sins. So, what can you do for Jesus today? What can I do for Jesus today? Well, we can do a lot by showing his love through our life, by sharing his love with all our neighbors and demons. Well, this is the time you need to invite all your friends and family to watch our videos. So, if you have not subscribed, you subscribe to our channel, invite your friends and family. Subscribe to our channel, hit the bell icon, follow us on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and do write to us on the email ID shown on the screens. Till later, God bless, Shalom.